Or not. Not all communities have the same access to quality schools and other resources that influence a child's life. Learn how you can help improve your community at hud.gov/fairhousing.
Topic because I am one of those people that are very bad. I've been learning to negotiate my salary more effectively and I've gotten better at it, but it terrifies me. So let's talk about, first of all, when is the right time to start negotiating your salary?
The best time to actually negotiate your salary is when you're coming into a job for the first time and you have a job offer in writing.
Okay.
In writing, because by that, that actually puts you in the most powerful position because you know that your employer has evaluated all of the other candidates.
Yeah.
Figured out that you're the best one and they really want you.
Okay.
Now, a lot of people think that maybe they should just accept a job with a salary that's not quite what they want, really hustle for 6 months or a year, and then ask for a raise after proving their worth. That's a little bit tougher to do because by then they know how much you're willing to settle for.
That's right.
So you're in less of a powerful position.
Where you start is so crucial. And my husband has been telling me this for about a decade.
Yeah.
Where you start is crucial because you are going to be going up from that place.
Yeah.
And you don't want it to be too low because you'll never be able to make that huge jump that you want to make just because you feel like, well, this is a meritocracy and I've been working so hard.
Yeah.
It doesn't work that way.
No, it doesn't.
Does
and
it?
There's a reason why there's the saying, the best time to get a raise is when you start your job.
Right.
Because then you can move up from there.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Now, what if you walk into a job interview and they actually ask you what your salary expectations are right there on the spot?
Yeah. So this is actually more common than it used to be. Some viewers might remember when they actually used to post salaries with the job posting. That's becoming more and more rare. So you really do have to go into your job interview having an idea of what your number is, which can be tricky. Really the best amount to ask for, so this is the big question I always get around salary negotiation, is, well, how much should I ask for? If I ask for too little, I'm going to be disappointed. If I ask for too much, they might go with somebody else. This is the big fear, right? Like, what if I ask for too much and it costs me the job?
Yes.
Well, the best salary to ask for, and this is tough, is a salary that you're actually going to be excited to get up to work for every day.
Yes.
Right?
$1 million!
$1 million would be great. And the reason why you should ask for an amount that actually you feel good about is because if you accept a salary you resent, you're actually going to be back, you know, not happy with your job very soon and doing another search very shortly.
That's right.
Yeah.
You don't want to be in a situation where you're waking up every day and you're thinking, my goodness, I'm being underpaid.
Yeah.
For the work that I'm doing, or you become resentful and you start doing less.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? So that's not a good situation for anybody.
Yeah.
What about the whole idea, and I think a lot of us try to fudge it, of giving a range? It's like, well, I really don't want to ask for the amount that I really want, so let me just give a range. Like, what's the danger in that?
Well, it's fine. What you need to keep in mind if you ask for a range instead of a specific number is, like, 90% of the time the employer's going to, if they're accepting your number, they're going to want the low end of the range, right? So you actually have to pad your ask at the higher end so that even if they negotiate you down to the lower end of your range, it's still an amount you're feeling really comfortable with.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a good way to do it. I want to just talk a little bit about people that are coming in and it is a union job. Like, is there any wiggle room there? You know what the categories are. You know what the amounts are. There's not really much you can do about that.
Yeah, for some jobs, there's very little wiggle room.
Yeah.
And so let's say you get a job offer and you counter offer. You might have someone say to you, you know, this is actually a capped salary in this class of a position, and they'll just let you know.
Right.
Now, that doesn't mean you shouldn't counter offer if they, you know, offer you an amount that you're not happy with.
Yeah.
If you counter offer and the salary is capped, they'll just tell you. So it's like literally the worst thing that will happen is they'll say no because it's capped.
Right.
But I still think it's always worth asking because you never really know if it's capped until you start having the conversation.
Yeah, there's always a little bit of discretion. And maybe you can go in and say, well, can you give me more vacation?
Yes.
Can
more
you get more
time,
can I get
benefits.
More benefits? Can I get flex time? That sort of thing. Let's talk a little bit about a counter offer if you're not happy with the absolute offer. So that means you're in a situation where you actually have to stand up and say, I'm worth more than this.
Yes.
How do you do that?
Well, this is something you want to do, again, after you have the job offer in writing.
Yeah.
Right? So you want to have it in writing. And There's sort of three rules of doing a counteroffer, I think, and one is to first express enthusiasm for the job, express interest in the job, and then to ask for the amount and demonstrate your value, right? So it always has to be tied to your value. It's not about, you know, even in the case of asking for a raise versus negotiating a new salary, it's not about, well, I've been here for this amount of time or I need it. It always has to tie back to the value you bring.
Okay, so you got to come in with your points and you have to be able to back up why you are worth more than that.
Yeah, and to do it unapologetically. A lot of people have fear around salary negotiation, especially us as women, because of the way we're socialized, right? Like, don't be too assertive, don't be too aggressive. These are the messages we grow up with as women. And so we get a little more nervous around salary negotiation, and you really have to be unapologetic about the ask, which can be tricky.
There's a lot of negative self-talk, I find, and I'm not going to say it's just women, but I hang out with women a lot, and I know we talk about it, the fact that there's always a voice in your head saying, well, maybe you're not worth it. Yeah. You're asking for too much. Yeah. They're going to go with someone else.
Yeah.
And so you have to really talk yourself out of that. There's been a lot in the news about wage parity, Ellen Pompeo, Michelle Williams, both actresses, Ellen Pompeo having to fight to get paid, even though Grey's Anatomy is named after her character. Why is this so common still, do you think?
Well, it hasn't been that long that women have really been showing up in the workplace in a way that is sort of equal with men in the views of employers and society. Like, women have been hustling since basically the world wars in the workplace, but really there are still some systems and systemic issues in the workplace that tend to value women less.
Yeah.
So we have to ask for more. We tend not to ask for more, and we tend to ask less frequently than men. So it's kind of like those two issues, the systemic issues along with the issues that we have as women around the intimidation to ask, or the intimidation around being perceived as
bossy
or entitled or aggressive. It's a real difficult cocktail for us.
It really is.
Yeah.
Okay, really good answer there. So guys, we just gotta ask. Sarah, thank you. Let's go to break. We got more coming up.
So simple, I'm almost embarrassed.
This was racy.
I know.
We got to keep the momentum going. We have that special thing.
It's so important to have this forum on Cityline to talk about it.
We only have this moment.
Just let it flow. We are the masters of our